So I'm TK, I'm with the team at Freenet Digital. We are based in Berlin. We are the old Jamba. So we are the guys that originally started through the Crazy Frog with ringtones over the TV, initially even on print. And I guess about 12 years ago, it moved all towards digital, and now we are a big advertiser, and we are what we call conversion management specialists. So we've moved away from just selling ringtones, of course, to doing anything to do with conversion management. Sure, I mean, at the end of the day, I guess all advertising on the digital environment is around the fact that we want to try and sell or bring a product or a service to a consumer, and that consumer sees a banner or a piece of text or a little video of that service, clicks on it and starts some type of interaction. And that interaction, if it's successful, it creates a conversion. And a conversion is either a lead that is generated, some people give their name and their phone number, or it goes as far as actually buying something and committing to a sale and then getting a product shipped or a service started. I think at the moment, the hottest topics are and have been for the last sort of 18 months, 24 months around fraud. There is so much going on in the entire area of fraud. The development automatically, therefore platform development and making sure that that's managed correctly, can never really get away from it completely, but if it managed correctly is where the development is going. I see the most new things in that area. Yeah, there are, of course, content-wise, a lot of different types of services that are going. So video has become, of course, even bigger. Broadband or access to broadband has become easier and easier. We've gone away from GPRS to 3G, 4G, and now we're all talking 5G. And phones that have got bigger screens, foldable stuff. So video is of course, much bigger, and different types of video content. And now games are becoming basically like video. They're being streamed instead of having to download a game. But actually now what we do is consumers are streaming the games, and they are playing games with hundreds of people at the same time, and the game is hosted somewhere on a server rather than on each machine, each device itself. So that's definitely a development. I think consumers are expecting, you know, the best quality or rather a seamless experience. So when they are streaming something, because in the past they used to have the games or even the video content on their local device, they expect it to be the same. And technology has gotten quite far with regards to, you know, not having buffering experiences, not having lag, those type of things. But at the same time, you know, the GSM network is at the end of the day based on antennas and people doing, you know, traveling, sitting on a bus or sitting on a train. There are challenges to do with infrastructure, I guess. And a train that runs at 210 kilometers an hour is not going to be able to deal with the fact that a customer is connected to one GSM mast and has to be handed over to the next GSM mast. And simply the infrastructure that was built for that in the original days is just not made for trains going, for the device traveling at that type of speed. So those are the type of challenges, I guess, that 5G and just in general development of infrastructure will solve in the future, at least we hope.